On the list of Elon Musk's favorite worlds that he often talks about, Mars is one of them.
The number of people in tonnage to Mars.
The Mars are only in the same.
So Mars may
he has a big plan to have a civilization on Mars.
You would eventually terraform Mars. At first, people would live in.
If he succeeds, it would be the first time humans would be setting foot on it. It sounds like a science fiction, but in the coming decades, it could be a reality.
First, people would live in some kind of protected environment like domes and underground kind of thing.
Not just Elon Musk's SpaceX, but the race to Mars is heating up. More big players like NASA and other global space agencies are spending billions of dollars on research and tests.
China has now launched Tianwen-1, its ambitious mission to planet Mars.
But why Mars? What challenges will astronauts face? How would it be to live on Mars? And could humanity actually build a second home there? Let's dive in. Mars is the most Earth-like planet in our solar system, making it the prime target for the human exploration. It has a day length similar to that of Earth's, polar ice caps, and evidence of ancient rivers and lakes. If we ever find life beyond Earth, Mars is a good place to start looking. Plus, establishing a human presence on Mars could serve as a backup plan for our species in case of global catastrophe. Traveling to Mars is no small feat. A one-way trip would take around 6 to 9 months, depending on the alignment of the planets. Astronauts would be exposed to cosmic radiation, microgravity, and the psychological toll of isolation. Not to mention, there's no turning back if something goes wrong mid-journey. To make a Mars mission successful, we need cutting-edge technology. SpaceX is developing the Starship rocket, which aims to be fully reusable for long-duration space travel. NASA's Artemis program, which is focused on returning humans to the moon, is laying on a groundwork for Mars by testing habitat designs and propulsion systems. AI and robotics will also play a major role, assisting astronauts with mining, construction, and repairs in the harsh Martian environment. Once we arrive to Mars, survival will be the next challenge. To what we know today, Mars has a thin atmosphere, freezing temperatures, and no breathable oxygen. Habitats will need to be pressurized and radiation shielded. Scientists are working on ways to generate oxygen from Mars' CO2-rich atmosphere using technology like MOXIE, a device that's already been tested on the Perseverance rover. Astronauts will need to grow their own food, as resupply missions from Earth would be costly and infrequent. Hydroponic and aerophonic farming could allow for sustainable food production. Water ice exists on Mars, but extracting and purifying it would be a challenge. Living on Mars comes to dangers. Radiation exposure, dust storms, and the psychological stress of being millions of miles away from home. But what are the rewards? Scientific discoveries, technological advancement, and the possibility of creating a self-sustaining colony. Some even dream of terraforming Mars, altering its atmosphere to make it more Earth-like, though that remains far in the future. Mars colonization raises big ethical questions. Who will govern Mars? Will it be owned by corporations or nations? Could it one day be self-sustaining? These are debates we need to start having now. With major players like NASA, SpaceX, and China making strides towards Mars missions, the first humans could set foot on the red planets within the next 2 decades. And if we succeed, it won't just be Mars. It will be the first step towards humanity becoming an interplanetary species. But what do you think? Will humans thrive on Mars, or are we underestimating the challenges? Drop your thoughts in the comments, and don't forget to like and subscribe for more deep dives into space exploration.